52.92, a new high school national record. Back to back to back to back state champions. NET Sports is Nebraska's home for championship sports, and we are live from the Pinnacle Bank Arena in Lincoln, Nebraska, for the 2016 NSAA Girls Basketball Championships. We conclude our day-long of state champions in Class C2 as Guardian Angels Central Catholic, the Bluejays, at 27-1 take on the Crofton Warriors at 24-3. And hello again, everyone. I'm Larry Putney along with Trudy Nolan. Good to have you with us. Our final game of the day. Six state champions throughout the day. The final one coming right now. Crofton, Guardian Angels, Central Catholic. We expect this to be a terrific game. Both teams with a lot of experience have been down here before. Crofton would like nothing more than to win another state championship.
Yeah, as you said, neither one of these teams are new to the state tournament, and neither one are new to the finals either. Crofton has been the four-time state champion in C2. They're going for their fifth straight championship in C2. And they, you know, with the great players that they have there, the juniors Monica Ahrens and Kelsey Sanger. Well, the Guardian Angels Central Catholic, their only loss is to Kearney Catholic, who we just crowned earlier today in C1. They're going to play pressure defense with a 2-2-1 press, and that causes lots of teams to have, you know, to turn the ball over. But their scoring is very even with the five starters. They shoot a lot of threes. They came out on fire yesterday. They scored 27 points in the first quarter. These two teams have seen each other this year. Guardian Angels came out on top two times, but you know how they say, it's hard to beat a team three times.
Should be a terrific game. The Crofton Warriors, sixth consecutive year in these finals, and there they are, the Guardian Angels Central Catholic Blue Jays, 25-1. Back here again. Should be a terrific state championship. Great way to finish it out here at the Pinnacle Bank Arena in Lincoln.
Head trauma and concussion risk minimization is a priority of the NSAA. When in doubt, sit them out.
Some common symptoms of concussions are dizziness, confusion, and nausea.
The NSAA requires coaches in all sports to take a concussion course annually.
For more information regarding concussion management and return to play protocol, visit our website, nsaahome.org. When in doubt, sit them out.
No matter how you look at it, animal agriculture helps Nebraska's economy. The livestock industry provides increased tax revenues for schools and community services. Livestock enterprises also create jobs while contributing to existing businesses such as local banks and grocery stores. A thriving livestock industry helps maintain our current way of life, but also provides opportunities for the next generation of farm families. The Nebraska Soybean Checkoff helps to raise awareness of the importance of animal agriculture to Nebraska.
Welcome back to Pinnacle Bank Arena. Lincoln, Nebraska, it's the final championship game on Championship Saturday. It's the Class C2 title game. Guardian Angels Central Catholic at 27-1, taking on the 24-3 Crofton Warriors. My name is Andy Kendi. I will be your in-game host, and I'll also have post-game interviews, but this one's going to be a good one. GACC against Crofton. Let's get this party started.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Nebraska School Activities Association and its member schools, welcome to Pinnacle Bank Arena for the Class C2 State Championship Game. Tonight's game features the 24-3 Crofton High School Lady Warriors versus the 27-1 Blue Jays of Guardian Angels Central Catholic High School. And now, let's meet the players and coaches competing in tonight's game. First, the non-starters for the visiting team, the Crofton Lady Warriors. Number 4, Allison Trapp. Number 10, Haley Arns. Number 12, Kyla Denninger. Number 14, Josie Sanger. Number 20, Caitlin Bornhagen. Number 22, Sam Altwine. Number 40, Lauren Stefan. number 42, Mariah Denninger. And number 44, Chelsea Wortma. And now, the non-starters for the home team, the Guardian Angels Central Catholic Blue Jays. Number 12, Michaela Tomka. Number 20, Morgan Brock. Number 24, Hannah Humke. Number 34, Maddie Kanabe. Number 40, Sarah Werdekemper. Number 42, Lauren Wapkin. Number 44, Ali Kanabe. Number 50, Maddie Brock. And number 52, Emily Reza. And now, the starting lineup for the Crofton Lady Warriors. A 5'5", senior number 3, Brianna Ella. A 5'1", senior number 5, Brittany Gunther. A 5'10", junior number 24, Monica Arns. A 5'7", junior number 32, Kelsey Sanger. And a 5'10", senior number 34, Katie Peterson. Head coach for Crofton is Aaron Losing, assisted by Tiffany Panning and Taylor Shoemaker. And now, the starting lineup for Guardian Angels Central Catholic High School. A 5'7", senior, number 10, Kate Kanabe. A 6'1", senior, number 14, Katie Brown. 5'9", senior number 22, Katie Stoider. A 5'8", sophomore number 30, Alexis Posse. And a 5'9", senior number 32, Brianne Krakemeyer. Head coach for the Blue Jays is Jerry Strachey, assisted by Kevin Krakemeyer and father Steve Emanuel. Tonight's game officials are Scott Johnson, Shannon Pogendorf, and Tyler Daly. The bench official is Jake Dilsaver. And now, ladies, let's play basketball!
Ready to go here in Class C2, our final state championship of the day. Guardian Angels Central Catholic, the Blue Jays, 27-1 against the Warriors of Crofton at 24-3, both again Northeast Nebraska, kind of that hotbed of basketball upper right-hand corner of our great state. Crofton comes in not having faced GAC. They did face each other one time this year, and GACC won that over Crofton 57-44. Actually played twice, and GACC won both of those. Here's how they got to this championship. GAC knocked off Stanton and Superior, while Crofton took care of UTAN and Hastings St. Cecilia. And that was a great game. St. Cecilia with an opportunity to win that game later, at least tie it against Crofton. So Crofton and GAC here in the state championship. There's the head coach, Aaron Losing, in his 12th year. Four-time defending state champs. They're doing something right in Crofton. Be keeping an eye on the young lady jumping the ball for Crofton, Monica Arns, who just won the tip. Monica, just a terrific player. She's been outstanding since her freshman year. We've seen her every year down here at state.
Yep.
And there she is off the front of the rim. Rebound pulled down by Caitlin Brown. Pushing tempo.
You know, Guardian Angel starts four seniors and then a sophomore, but I'm going to tell you, as you watch Lexus, she does not play like a sophomore. She's
right.
Very comfortable out there with the other girls.
Jump ball. Tied up. Brittany Gaither. There's head coach Jerry Strachey, 14 years. 326-43 in his career. Very balanced offensive attack. Hard to key on any one player. They average across the board 9, 10, 8, 7.
You know, that's a nice thing to have where you have all of your team,
right,
your starters, and, you know, even those coming in contributing.
Katie Peterson picks up the foul. Well, Kenobi now at the line. She knocks down the first one. And Kenobi gets them both. Two-zip lead, Gack early on, breaking the press very efficiently. Tipped out of bounds by Kenobi.
And that's that 2-2-1 press that Guardian Angel tries or likes to do all the way down the floor, hoping for those turnovers. And they have caused a lot of turnovers here at the state tournament for other teams.
Three on the way. Got it. Back down the three. Brianna Allen buries it. Crofton back on top. Or on top for the first time.
And Crofton playing the man-to-man defense.
Three the other way is short. And here comes Arnes. Another three on the way off the front of the rim. Rebound. Lexi Haas. Shot is long. Pulled down by Strader. Taken away by the Warriors. And another turnover.
And Guardian Angels in a 2-3 zone, but they'd like to double on the ball and give lots of pressure on the ball in that 2-3 zone.
Kearney Catholic loss earlier in the year for the Blue Jays was a big one because really told them they could compete with anybody, playing a class up against one of the top teams, a team that made a state championship in Kearney Catholic and only losing by three, and really that game would late in the game, 48-45, but the competition all year long has been terrific for Guardian Angels Central Catholic. Three is off, rebound to Peterson. Another three in and out by Allen. Thought she had that down. Good three-point threat is Allen. She's an NAI basketball recruit. Not sure where she's going yet. On the watch list of many coaches. Here's Kenobi driving in. Shot tipped away, rallied in by Allen. Oh, good drive.
It was
strong.
That was a good drive by Sanger. Looks like she's got, you know, a couple, I don't know if she's got something wrong with her fingers there. She's got those all taped up. But I was watching during warm-ups. It doesn't seem to bother when she shoots, though.
Good give right back to Strider. Strider with the bucket. And the foul down low. Well, feeling out period here early on. The foul is called on Kenobi. That'll put Sanger at the line. You see Sanger's numbers on the year. Averages 11, 4 rebounds. Shot a bit long by Sanger. Crofton Warrior team lost 4 seniors off of last year's championship team. Usually, when you go on a run like that, where you've won 4 consecutive and you lose 4 seniors, you think, well, there was your secret sauce. And now, back to reality, but not in Crofton. Reality is you're going to be down here every year at state. Great Katie Brown.
Yeah, you know, they're one of the many schools in Nebraska that just has this basketball dynasty going on up there. And I know it probably starts, and Aaron is continuing that with the younger players there in Crofton as well.
Timeout on the floor. We'll take a timeout as well. First period action here in the C2 title game.
Been around for more than a century, you understand the power of generations, the value of nurturing and developing those who will carry on the legacy of agriculture and food production. That's why the Aurora Cooperative helps young people gain the experience, expertise, and wisdom to feed the world, be good stewards, become responsible community leaders, and continue setting the example for the generations that follow. The Aurora Cooperative, growing opportunities.
Welcome back to the Century, to Pinnacle Bank Arena, I should say. And look at this, we're at the Crofton fan section, and look at these guys. These guys are wild up. We got a baby, we've got, I have no idea, greatest American superhero. And look at this, Trudy, they're chanting your name, Trudy. You have your own fan club, Trudy.
Get my fan club going over
and
there.
And I apologize. I had CenturyLink Center on the brain. I was just talking to Wrestling Ron. We're going to talk to him at halftime about the success of the wrestling program. So that's just a tease for our halftime program.
That's just another Saturday night in Adams for Trudy. Arnes with the drive. Left hand in and out. Good rebound. Pulled away by Madeline Kenobi.
Stays in that tough man-to-man defense. The other thing is they're, you know, really focusing in on those bottom post players as well. Arnes is working down there trying to get in front.
And a hunky now into the game. She has the ball, the 5'5 junior guard. Now off to Kenobi. And Kenobi calls for the charge and kind of chuckles as Maddie Kenobi called for the charge.
Was that a thought that she touched her as much as they did? There's a little contact there. Might have seen a little contact on that play there, but it was a good drive to the basket.
Arnes now into the game for Crofton. Sorry, Pete.
That's all right. Guardian Angels just goes, you know, really deep on their bench. He'll keep bringing them in, mainly because I think they try to do this on the it's a 2-3 zone, but they really double the ball wherever it goes. So they're really moving hard on that 2-3 zone. Sometimes you think when you play zone, you kind of stand around, but not when they're doubling on everywhere the ball goes.
Tens get tied up there as Arnes and Kenobi. With the jump ball, possession arrow belongs to Crofton. Crofton trailing by 4 here early in this Class C2 state championship game. And Arnes with the jumper. And she's on the board. On the way, taken away off the turnover. Rosie Sanger with the takeaway. Rosie Sanger with it, double team down low. What pulls that out of there, does not let it get tied up. Picks it out for the three and knocked down by Sanger. Josie, the freshman, kicks it out to Kelsey, the junior, and the Sangers get it done. Foul called on, I believe that's Josie Sanger. Here's a look at that.
Yeah, look at Josie passing it out there to Kelsey and giving Crofton actually the, you know, one of the first leads that they have had of this game. They led one other time when it was 3-2, but now leading 9-8. Now it's 9-9 on that free throw.
The other impressive thing in that last play is Josie, the freshman, was trapped on the baseline, and typically we've seen that so many times today where the ball gets tied up. She did not allow that to get tied up. She ripped it out of there and got that pass back up top, found the open shooter to knock it down. These are the open shooters. Allen not afraid to put it up. Put right back. Good stuff on it. Arnes. And Monica Arnes back-to-back buckets. All of a sudden, Crofton on a bit of a run here. They're up 11-9. Nothing there for Stoiter.
Monica doing some, you know, great defense down there low. They've been looking. Kathleen down there has been trying to post up, but Monica doing a great job of defending.
Seconds to go here in period number one. Big shot as Gack regains that lead. And the foul called with 1.8 left. The foul will be called on Kenobi. That is her second foul. So Kenobi will take a seat. Crofton will try to get a shot up here with 1.8. Nope, not time for that. So after one, Guardian Angels Central Catholic, the Blue Jays with the lead, 12-11. Here in Lincoln.
I had 29 students in my class.
We've been together since kindergarten.
High school, 4 years of growing up.
Growing together. Senior year.
I am done with school.
I'm invincible.
They don't understand me.
Forget about it. Let's have fun.
I had 29 students in my class.
Participating in Nebraska high school activities has taught me about teamwork.
I've learned how to lead among my peers.
At my high school, I have set goals and I work hard to accomplish them.
I like to run on my cross country team. It makes me feel good about myself.
The Nebraska School Activities Association providing opportunities in 25 activities in our 303 high schools. NSAA activities, the other half of education.
So we are back in Lincoln. Guardian Angels Central Catholic with the lead on Crofton in the Class C2 State Championship game. I want to remind you, you don't want to miss the NSAA Nebraska High School Boys State Basketball Finals. Those are next Saturday on NET Sports. Watch all the live action beginning at 9 a.m. Central right here on NET Sports. You can check out our website, too. You can see the game there as well. Or on the Nebraska NET Nebraska app. Quick entry pass doesn't quite make it there. Krakmeyer was trying to get that off in a hurry.
Yeah, now Guardian Angels setting up in their 2-2-1 press, which they try to get those turnovers on that. Crofton does a good job of breaking that.
Three is off, and Crofton 2 of 6 from outside the arc. Here early in period number two. Talk about Crofton's trip here to the state championship. They knocked off UTAN in the first round. No trouble there. It was 64-28. But boy, was that semifinal game something against St. Cecilia. Crofton won it 28-26, just a defensive slugfest. It was 19-12 after three periods. They were down. They outscored them 14-9 in the fourth. Check that they were up going in. They outscored 14-9 to hold on to win it by two. Good Crofton. Down the three-pointer, Brianna Allen. That's why they keep shooting. Good shooters.
Yeah, she's a good three-point shooter, and you know, I think we've seen her down here shooting those threes for Crofton as well.
Good pass underneath and the foul on Bree Allen. Brianna picks up her first, is that first or second? With her second.
Look at that, on that back cut there to Lexus.
Second foul, free throw up and good. Sanger and Arnes back into the game now for the Warriors. And Maddie Kenobi also into the game for the Blue Jays. Crofton now with it, all tied at 14. Warriors average 61.5 points a game. They only allow 35 per game. And we talked about the schedule that both of these teams have played, but Crofton has not been afraid to step up and take on some of the top teams in the region. One of their three losses is to one of the big school teams, large class school teams in South Dakota, in Sioux Falls or Gorman. That's the parochial school in Sioux Falls. They lost that 43-34, but you know, they're stepping up about three levels to take on a Sioux Falls or Gorman. But they did beat one of the large class schools in Sioux City, Sioux City Healing, which is also the parochial in Sioux City. They beat them 63-51. And then also beat St. Thomas More of South Dakota. That, by the way, is the number one ranked team and three-time defending champion Class A in South Dakota.
Yeah, and that, we talked about that today, that it can make a difference in the type of schedule that you play. You know, and if you look at, I mean, they beat Pierce twice.
Right.
And Pierce has been, you know, a big threat here at the state tournament, made it to the semifinals here as well. So, yeah, that schedule can make a big difference, can, you know, make your team come down here and be able to play all three of those days at a competitive rate.
Stoiter draws the charge, and she was a bit excited about that. Let's look one more time. Yeah, good call.
Guardian Angels likes to stay very patient on offense, run through things, look for that open player. As we've talked about, their scoring is very, you know, among all the players. So that's why they can run and be patient and look for the open shot.
Foul down low. That'll put Maddie Kenobi at the line. Foul called on Sanger. That's Sanger's first foul. Back into the game for the Blue Jays is Kate Kenobi. And shooting right there is Maddie Kenobi. Maddie averages 8.5 a game, 4 rebounds. And back in for Crofton is Brianna Allen with 2 fouls. And she'll be careful. 6 points, 2 fouls for Bree Allen here early on. Second free throw is off, rebound by Arnes. Sanger with it up top. Good ball movement. 1-3-1, the zone that the Blue Jays are in. Arnes loses the ball, picks it up, and goes straight up.
And that's one of those, you know, Mark Kruger was talking about in the game. Sometimes the ball can bounce the right way and sometimes it doesn't. And right there it did for Arnes as she tried to drive to the basket, make a good drive to the basket.
Ripped away by Kelsey Sanger. Pushes it up the other way, kicks it back out. Arnes thought about the three. Now back to Sanger, who drives in and can't get the layup to go. Aaron losing, shrugged his shoulders and said, that's what we want. Jump ball off the rebound. Back into the game now for Crofton is Katie Peterson. Katie Peterson comes in for Josie Sanger, who goes out, and also leaving the game is Hannah Hunke. And in for Hunke is Alexis Huss.
You know, it's just a difference that you see between each of the games, but both of these coaches just being very calm on the bench. And you know, I'm sure both of the they've been here enough. They know what they're supposed to do at this point and the things that they have been doing all season long as well.
Well, they probably assume, well, we know it's going to go down to the final minute anyway, so let's get there as soon as we can. When we get there, then we'll make some moves and decide how we're going to win this. A turnover on the Blue Jays over and back.
Has happened all but one game.
Right.
That game was 10 points, so
right.
Had, you know, a lot of great games out of the five games we've had so far.
One of the better state tournaments I can remember this year, just in terms of quality games, all of them going down to the end.
Yeah, it really is. And as you talk about Guardian Angels, you know, they play a 2-3 zone and then they kind of switch to almost a 1-3-1 or a 3-2. They bring that middle person up really high on the arc there and try to force, you know, a turnover out there and kind of leave the inside a little bit more open.
The coach did say it was more of a 3-2, not necessarily a 1-3-1, although it can give that appearance.
Yeah, now they're back in a 2-3.
Yep.
That's that pressure of doubling over the ballers.
Foul called. And going to the line to shoot. Foul is called on Kreichmeier. One more look.
That as Allen takes it to the hoop there.
Gives it the body language and gets it to drop. Hunke, one of the more improved players on the team, now into the game. And another turnover. There's Jerry Strachey.
Crofton being very patient.
Ripped away, taken away by Kenobi. Down low to Kenobi, and she's fouled.
That's a good cut to the basket by Kate Kenobi.
Fouled by Haley Arnes. That's her first. It rolls out for Kenobi. First miss at the line. Very good free throw shooting team, both of these squads. six of nine in the game right now is GACC on the line. Free throw waved off as that toe just touched the line. Steal by Krackmeyer, just couldn't keep that foot down. Trying to keep her balance.
And that's that 2-2-1 press that they like to, you know, cause turnovers for the other teams, which they have done while they are down here. Especially, you know, on their first game when they played Stanton, that was a big key to that game, was their 2-2-1 press and causing the turnovers. Right.
Lofted up by three, 18-15, 1:30 to go here before halftime.
And now we're back in that 3-2. They like to do that when Caitlin Brown is in there. She likes to come up high, you know, kind of a bigger figure up there, causing the problems in the passing lane.
Kicked outside. Up top, three on the way by Sanger. That's off the front. Chased down by Peterson, who kept it alive. Good job by Crofton to gain another possession. Play called out by Allen.
Crofton wants to stay pretty, you know, patient right here. They got 37 seconds. They're ahead by three. Going into halftime, hopefully taking that lead.
Arms gets it down low, throws it up, and she's fouled. Nice, patient possession for the Warriors. And Arns with the basket.
There's a look at Arns taking it up very strong to get that ball in there and to make that three-point play here. With a chance to put them up now by six.
Three-point play converted for Monica Arns.
You know, that puts Crofton at the biggest lead that we've had here, you know, between either team, is the six-point lead that Crofton has with 25 seconds left before half.
Thanks to a 7-0 run by the Warriors. Driving in, foul. That will be called on Kelsey Sanger. That's her second personal foul.
Kelsey Sanger, her second personal, number nine for the Bluejays.
Bluejays now will shoot 1-1. Check that, she was shooting. That's it too. So Gunther back in, Brittany Gunther, 5'1 senior guard. Second free throw off the front of the rim, tipped around, rebound to the Blue Jays. Five left. Shot on the way from Strider, got it. Strider knocks it down right at the buzzer. That'll give him a little momentum heading into that halftime locker room. Crofton on top, 21-18, one more look. Stoyer kind of throws it up.
She was very excited that she made it as well.
That'll provide some momentum. Let's go down, or let's go over to Andy Kendi.
Yeah, Larry, here with Aaron Lotson, the head coach of the Crofton Warriors. Coach, you had a 7-0 run before giving up that last hoop. What are you most happy about the first half?
We're playing good defense. We're competing real hard. Our kids are playing with confidence on offense. Ball's not always going through the hoop, but we're staying aggressive. I like what I'm seeing out of us.
What do you adjust at halftime? Do you say just keep doing what you're doing since it's working?
You know, we've given up some offensive boards and given them some second chances. That's something we got to clean up. I mean, they're a big team. They're a physical team. They're a rebounding team. That's something that we got to make sure we compete on the boards with.
Good luck in the second half, Coach. Coach Aaron Losing. The Crofton Warriors are up 21-18, halfway home to another state championship. Halftime festivities. Straight ahead.
Constellation believes in developing the next generation of Nebraska leaders, and we show that support by contributing to 4-H and FFA in the 60 Nebraska counties we serve. More than $120,000 over the past 4 years. Constellation provides natural gas for Nebraska homes, farms, ranches, and businesses. Through our support for 4-H and FFA, we're providing energy for Nebraska's future as well. Natural gas from Constellation.
Take back your garage. Stuck with an extra vehicle that's taking up needed space? Donate it and get your garage back again. Support quality public media and get a tax deduction.
Coverage of the 2016 NSAA Girls High School Basketball Championships on NET is made possible in part by the Nebraska Soybean Board, the Nebraska Tourism Commission, Nebraska Public Power District, and Education Quest. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. Good game at halftime. It's Crofton on top by 3 in the Class C2 state championship game. Why don't we take a look at last year's C2 title?
Last year's Class C2 state title game featured the Crofton Warriors versus the Hastings St. Cecilia Hawkettes, a repeat of the previous 3 years. In each of those games, Crofton came out victorious over Hastings St. Cecilia. The Hawkettes tried to end that streak by holding the Warriors scoreless in the first quarter and taking a lead into the fourth quarter, both firsts against this Crofton team. Behind the play of senior Quinn Rogge, Crofton found their edge and rolled to a 9-0 run that put the Warriors out in front for good. For the fourth year in a row, the Crofton Warriors defeated the Hastings St. Cecilia Hawkettes for a Class C2 state crown.
And Crofton is ready to roll, and they're 2 quarters away from a 5th straight championship. They lead GACC 21-18 at halftime. Andy Kendi along with Ron Higdon. He's in charge of wrestling for the NSAA. Let's talk about the recent individual wrestling tournament. I mentioned the CenturyLink Center by mistake. It's so late I mixed the arenas up when talking about basketball. I had CenturyLink Center on the brain because it is such a perfect venue for your wrestling tournament, isn't it?
It is. It is. They've done a great job embracing us, embracing our fans, and really being innovative with what they can do with our championships and making it a spectacle for the fans.
We were talking earlier about ticket sales and records. Tell me a little bit about it. It was a banner year for wrestling.
It was. You know, our coaches throughout the regular season do a great job of promoting their own programs, and it shows at the end of the year. For the last 2 years, we've set a record sales for tickets.
And it's a unique format that you've installed where when there's a wrestler, you try to have him end the meet. So you kind of start, you stagger, you start a different weight class. And Isaac DeLoa of Millard South was the one wrestler that was going for 4, so he was the final wrestler of the day. That's pretty unique.
It is. The NFHS allows us to do some of that stuff, and it's kind of like the main event. So like in boxing or MMA or whatever, they choose the best fight to have that at the end. So our best match or our highlight person is going to be at the end of the night. It just so happened over the last couple of years that the team race and some of the other divisions came down to that last couple of matches too, so I got lucky.
Yeah. You know? Come on, Doe. That's a genius invention by you, and it really brought a lot of excitement to the wrestling tournament. Now, there's also a dual wrestling tournament, which is a week later. Tell us a little bit more about that, and how successful has that been?
Well, this was the fourth year that we've had the duels, and our membership voted it in because a dual team is significantly different than a tournament team. So if you have a good dual team, it doesn't necessarily mean you'll do as well in the individual tournament and vice versa. So the membership wanted to implement the dual championships, and they have. And we've had closer duels as the time has gone on. This is the fourth year in a row, and every year the duels get closer. Amherst is a dominant team in Class D, and they had the 6th seed in the finals, and it was tied 30-30 with the last 2 matches. So it's exciting for the fans. It's exciting for our teams. Our coaches are getting it more embraced. And it does a better job of embracing the casual fan instead of just somebody that's connected with wrestling.
Well, you're doing great work with the wrestling, both at the dual meet level and the individual level. It's Ron Higdon. He's in charge of the wrestling program for the NSAA. Halftime of the final state championship game of the day. Crofton leading GACC 21-18.
Whether it's spring planting, fall harvesting, or just a drive across the state, soy biodiesel helps a diesel-powered engine operate in a demanding job. Soybean oil from Nebraska soybeans makes biodiesel a renewable fuel that's also environmentally responsible. The Soybean Checkoff plays a major role in supporting the use and availability of biodiesel. The Nebraska Soybean Board, growing opportunity from the ground up.
Over the years, the Nebraska Chiropractic Physicians Association has supported many Nebraska athletes by helping them excel physically. But the mental game is just as important. That's why we're pleased to sponsor the NSAA Academic All-State Award Program, recognizing students and athletes who shine in the classroom and as leaders. We're proud to team up with these exceptional individuals. Together, we can continue to make Nebraska a great place to live, learn, and play.
Texting? Turn it off. If driving isn't worth your full attention, what is? A safety reminder from your Nebraska Department of Roads.
When you're looking for Nebraska's stars of tomorrow, start with the young Nebraskans in 4-H and FFA. Over the past 4 years, Constellation has given more than $120,000 to 4-H and FFA in the 60 Nebraska counties we serve. Constellation provides natural gas for Nebraska homes, farms, ranches, and businesses. By supporting 4-H and FFA, we're providing energy for Nebraska's stars of tomorrow as well. Natural gas from Constellation.
Back at the Pinnacle Bank Arena, Larry Putney along with Trudy Owen. Good to have you with us. Perusing the sidelines is Andy Kendi. We're at halftime of the Class C2 State Championship. Let's take a look at first half highlights between these two. We'll start with the Warriors. They're not firing. Brianna Allen with the three.
Yeah, you know, and then looking inside, there's Arns as they can do. That's where they have that inside and outside play there. And then again on the outside is Allen with that three-point shot, keeping them in on that side with Crofton keeping that lead. And then also the good defensive play by Sanger there. And a good look inside again at Arns as she takes it up really strong as she was contested there, but took it up really strong and made it a three-point play as well. And then for the Blue Jays on the other end, they're playing good defense there. Get a good outlet. They move the ball up the floor. They look inside, you know, there to Stroyder as well to get that bucket. And here's Caitlin Brown taking it in off the glass. A good drive. And on the outside, Kanabi getting that outside shot there. And as we've talked about, you know, Guardian Angels, they're very level with their scores. All the players, you know, have a very similar average. As you kind of look at the stats here for the first half, you know, everything is very similar.
Very tight,
there's
yeah.
not a whole lot of, you know, not a big difference. Maybe their turnovers for GACC, but even that isn't a whole lot different. And so you just kind of look and say that they both have played a solid first half, done some of the very same types of things. They're just running different defenses, but everything looks the same. Yeah. It's been a good first half of basketball here for the C2.
Let's go to Andy Kendi.
All right, Larry, thank you. With Jerry Strachey, the head coach of GACC. Coach, what did you like best about the first half?
You know, right now I think we need to focus on executing a little bit better on offense. Defensively, we're doing okay, but we still need to locate and find some of their players.
Yeah, talking to Aaron Losing over there, he says he loved his defense. How are you going to be more effective offensively?
We need to be, we're a little too timid right now. We need to be a little more aggressive, a little more assertive, and maybe attack the basket a little bit better.
All right, well, good luck in the second half. Jerry Strachey, the head coach of GACC. They're trailing by 3 points. The final two quarters of Championship Saturday, straight ahead.
Head trauma and concussion risk minimization is a priority of the NSAA. When in doubt, sit them out.
Some common symptoms of concussions are dizziness, confusion, and nausea.
The NSAA requires coaches in all sports to take a concussion course annually.
For more information regarding concussion management and return to play protocol, visit our website, nsaahome.org. When in doubt, sit them out.
Are you cool to flex fuel? One in seven Nebraskans is driving a flex fuel vehicle, and many don't even realize it. With a flex fuel vehicle, you can fill up with any blend of American ethanol and gasoline, from E10 to E15, from E30 to E85, at any time, in any amount. Look for an insignia on your trunk or tailgate. You might have a yellow gas cap, or check your owner's manual. If you're cool to flex fuel, then look for a flex fuel pump in your neighborhood. Flex fuel blends with American ethanol.
Coverage of the 2016 NSAA Girls High School Basketball Championships on NET is made possible in part by U.S. Bank, the Nebraska Corn Board, Constellation, and the Aurora Cooperative. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We couldn't do it without your support. We are ready to go. Second half action, Class C2 State Championship, our final state title game of the day. The Blue Jays and the Warriors, Crofton and GACC, perennial powers here at state. Crofton in the state championship game for the sixth consecutive year, looking for their fifth straight title. And the foul on Crofton. Foul by Blue Katie Peterson. If so, that's her third. Check that, it's Monica Arnes. So Arnes picks up her second.
You know, Crofton comes out, they're playing that man-to-man defense. That's what they like to stay in. But Guardian Angels made a good adjustment there by doing that screen and roll there and opening up Stoiter on the roll.
Stoiter knocks down the free throws, 21-20. Here's Sanger driving in. Good take by Kelsey Sanger. Nice drive for the future college recruit. It's good all-around skills on offense. All-stater. She'll have a chance to play at the next level. Put back. Rebound put back by Kate Brown. Katie Brown. Three on the way is off and out on the Warriors.
You know, when the Guardian Angel stays in that 2-3 zone, but again, just the pressure, the double teaming that they do on the ball can cause those turnovers.
Good pass inside. Loose ball. Picked up by the Blue Jays to keep it alive. But boy, what a great pass inside. Just could not finish. Arnes working hard in there.
And that was one of the things, you know, that Jerry said they have to execute better, and they've come out and they have done two possessions there where they executed the ball very well.
Arnes taking it strong all the way. Ball picked out of her hand by Alexis Hasse. Hasse, good pass inside. Just misses the lay-in by Kreichmeier. Spots up, sets her feet, knocks it down. Allen took her time, tapped those feet twice, and buried it.
That puts her for the game at 50% from that 3-point. She's 3-for-6 from there.
Off the front of the rim, and the rebound pulled away by Peterson. Sanger, that is, and Sanger pushes pace up the floor, and she's fouled. Sanger will go to the line. Foul on Stoiter. That's her first.
You know, as Coach Losing said at halftime, you know, he thinks that they're competed very well the first half. He liked what he saw. He likes where they are. It looks like they're coming out the second half with that same intensity.
Pass inside and the foul from underneath. That foul is going to be on Sanger, I believe. Sanger picks up her third. So three now on Kelsey Sanger.
Guardian Angels on their offense, you know, I think are looking a lot more inside at Stoyter and also at Brown. I think trying to push that inside, and maybe they're hoping that will open up the outside so they can shoot those outside threes.
There's Sanger with it. Spots up to Sanger, back to three-pointer. And Crofton just shooting lights out at the timeout. Two of three from three-point range here in the second half for Crofton, and they are on a 7-0 run over the last 55 seconds.
There's that shot by Kelsey Sanger to put that three in and to give them an 8-point lead, which is the largest lead that Crofton has had the whole game. And so for them to come out, like I said, with that competitiveness and to get after it here right away in the second half.
Guardian Angels Central Catholic also has missed its last four trips down the floor, last four field goals, 0 for 4. Combine that with Crofton's hot shooting, 2 for 3 from the outside the arc, and you've got a 7-zip run. Crofton on top, 30-22.
Yeah, you know, and the other part with the Guardian Angels is at the free throw line, where they're shooting 8 for 15 right now at 53%. And Crofton is 5 for 7 at 71%.
Another foul down low. That's going to be on Maddie Kenobi. Second foul. Check that foul on Peterson. Down low, off glass, and the bucket by King Brown.
Yeah, they really are doing a nice job of looking inside and trying to open that up down on the block.
Well, Sanger and Peterson now for Crofton with three fouls. Brittany Gunther picks up her first. Already Crofton at 4 team fouls at about the 5-minute mark here in period number 3.
Down low, Maddie Kenobi trying to post up down there, and Arne's doing a great job on defense.
Sanger picks up another foul. Reaching in right there, and that is foul number 4 on Kelsey Sanger. So here we are, not even halfway through period number 3, and Kelsey Sanger, the junior guard who averages 11 points a game, had 14 in the first round, will sit for an extended period of time.
Yeah, and that hurts Crofton right there because she does a great job of controlling the tempo, controlling the ball for them, and especially made that big three here that made it a shift and put them ahead by 8.
Working over the officials, still staring him down, not really liking that last call, still chirping at him.
And I don't think he likes it right now that it's 5-1 on the fouls.
Right. Stoyter down low to Kenobi. Get it to drop. Still
a 5-point lead for Crofton. Gets it out to Arns. 10-second call. 10-second backcourt call. Good defense by the Blue Jays. 2 championship game. Crofton on top by 5.
Programming on NET Television is made possible in part by U.S. Bank. U.S. Bank knows the importance of giving back. That's why we're committed to support charitable, educational, and service organizations in communities across Nebraska and the nation. Last year, U.S. Bank employees provided more than 3,000 hours of community service in Nebraska, and we're dedicated to continuing that support. U.S. Bank, serving you in Nebraska. Member FDIC.
Are you cool to flex fuel? 1 in 7 Nebraskans is driving a flex fuel vehicle, and many don't even realize it. With a flex fuel vehicle, you can fill up with any blend of American ethanol and gasoline, from E10 to E15, from E30 to E85, at any time, in any amount. Look for an insignia on your trunk or tailgate. You might have a yellow gas cap, or check your owner's manual. If you're cool to flex fuel, then look for a flex fuel pump in your neighborhood. Flex fuel blends with American ethanol.
Back at the Pinnacle Bank Arena, it's 30-25. Crofton looking for its 5th consecutive state championship. Have the slight lead here, but right now the foul is going against Crofton. Momentum has shifted the way of the Blue Jays. Down low. That rattles in and out. Just can't get the shots to fall. Goes up strong, and another foul. That's going to be called on Arns, and that's her 3rd personal. And now the Warriors are in serious foul trouble as Arns with 3, Sanger with 4. Peterson with 3, all of those starters for the Warriors.
Yeah, that is making a big difference. And at the timeout, you know, Aaron Losing was not happy about that foul situation right now. And I think he feels, you know, right now it's 6-1. But the other thing is the Guardian Angels are being very patient and trying to get it inside. And Crofton just isn't able to do anything after they get it inside there but to foul him on the shot.
Back into the game now is Katie Peterson with those 3 fouls. So both Peterson and Arns in the game with 3 fouls. Sanger obviously sitting with the 4. Gets it off to Arns. That full court pressure causing some problems. Little scoop shot. Arns got her own read back, goes back up, and she is fouled by Hasse.
Yeah, you know, and with Sanger out right now, Guardian Angels still staying up on that press that they have, but Arns being able to help bring the ball down the floor since Sanger is out.
Monica Arns shooting 2 shots.
Let's take a look at this foul trouble for Coach Aaron Losing's Crofton Warriors. You see Sanger with 4. Peterson with 3, Arns with 3, all 3 of those starters, and that's what Aaron Losing has been sure to make sure that Shannon Hagendorf's crew, Tyler Daly, Scott Johnson, make sure they all know exactly what's going on out there. His words, not mine.
Yeah. We could tell by the look that he was given.
That's exactly right. Allen now, Brianna Allen, another starter. Oh, by the way, 3 fouls. This is some...
Especially when we're 3 minutes left in the third. We've got a
right.
Whole fourth quarter to go yet.
Right. 4 of your 5 starters have 3-plus fouls.
Now, that might make a difference because right now they're playing man-to-man pressure defense. They may have to make a change on that.
Rebound goes back to the Blue Jays off the miss from Kenobi.
And they have made that change. They are in a zone now.
Hasse knocks down the 3. And look out, Gack within 1. 8-1 GACC run. And this full court pickup has been causing some issues for the Warriors. Gunther with it, looking for some help. Push is called on Kathleen Stoiter.
You know, the momentum was starting to change, but here's the three by Alexis, by Lexus there, you know, to give them within one. The momentum was starting to change before Sanger got her fourth, but since she's got her fourth, it really has changed, and Guardian Angels have really taken control right now.
Here's Gunther with it now over. Back up top. Arnes, nowhere to go there. Gunther picks it up. Here's Sanger. Gunther's three is just off. Sanger goes up for the rebound, tipped around, and it will go to the Blue Jays. 2:06 to go in the third.
You know, and Josie Sanger, the sister, is only ninth grader that's on that team. So right. She's got to step in here in the state finals and, you know, step up their her play here for stepping in for her sister.
Three is off. Orange is left to shoot and pick up number four right there. Goes off the Warriors. It will stay with the Jays. Inbounding is Brown. Three on the way. Knocked down by Hunky.
One of the problems is Crofton has had to go to a 2-3 zone, mainly because of the foul situation they're in. And that's when Guardian Angels now starting to shoot their threes that they can shoot.
And another turnover for the Warriors. You are right. They are missing Kelsey Sanger out there, who leads that show. It was 30-22 when Kelsey Sanger picked up that fourth foul. Since then, it's an 11-1 GACC run.
The worst part is, you know, what do you do fourth period? Do you go ahead and let her start in there with four? Do you have to sit her a little bit longer to wait? But I don't think Erin probably can wait any longer. You're gonna have to get her in the fourth.
Good pass. Did not finish. Barnes didn't get it to go. Brown drives in. Good bucket by Katie Brown, the 6-foot senior guard who averages 10 a game. She's going to play her basketball at Missouri S&T next year. Actually, she played for the team last year, but didn't get to come to state because she had mono.
And, you know, Guardian Angels, they've had quite the injuries this year as well that they've had to work through. And I think that's what gives their bench has had to come in throughout the year and do some playing time with some, you know, key players being gone as well.
Maddie Kenobi picks up her second foul. Arnes now to shoot two.
You know, we've talked about this switch of momentum, but since halftime, Guardian Angels have scored 17 to Crofton's 11. So a big switch, and right before halftime, we had that, you know, with Crofton going on a little run there. So we've talked about this today with the runs of the game and, you know, going in your favor as well.
35-33. Crofton 0 for its last four field goals. Tipped high in the air. And the turnover. Good takeaway by Crofton to try to keep it. First called on Guardian Angels Central Catholic.
Yeah, good defense down there by Allen to get that steal, especially with 15.9 left in the third quarter for Crofton to be able to get a basket here to either tie or go ahead by one.
The Warriors who led it at half down trail as we head to the fourth. Blue Jays. Horn in the threes on top 35-33.
Participating in Nebraska high school activities has taught me about teamwork.
I've learned how to lead among my peers.
At my high school, I have set goals and I work hard to accomplish them.
I like to run on my cross country team. It makes me feel good about myself.
The Nebraska School Activities Association providing opportunities in 25 activities in our 303 high schools. NSAA activities, the other half of education.
All right, college visit number two. Here we go.
What?
Learn more from Education Quest at govisitcollege.org.
Here's a look at the foul trouble. You'll see Stanger, Peterson, Arnes, Allen, all in foul trouble. And how long does he keep Kelsey Stanger on the bench? That's the question. And the answer is not long. She's in the game.
And you know, one of the big keys of the second half here was the Guardian Angels. They came out, they're looking inside, but they're also getting second chance shots. As you see it, they've gotten 15 points off the second chance shots, and a lot of those were the start of the second half here.
Dropped into a 3-2 zone now to try to defend against that foul trouble with Sanger back in the game. Three on the way, bounces right into the hands of Stoiter, who pulls down the rebound. Another opportunity here for the Blue Jays. Up by two in the fourth. Ball movement by the Blue Jays, working that defense. The skip pass into the hands of Brown, who reeled it in. Brown again, three-pointer on the way. Katie Brown off the front. And another long rebound into the hands of the Blue Jays.
Yes, I think they've had, is it three shots here? Almost in 2 minutes.
And knocked it down. Kenobi carries the three. Minute and a half into this fourth period. And this is the Warriors' first possession of the fourth. Doesn't take them long to score as Monica Arnes goes right to the basket, and a quick timeout called by Aaron Losing.
It's the 32nd timeout.
Last three-pointer by Grant. Check that, Guardian Angels Central Catholic, and I'm assuming most know by now because Guardian Angels Central Catholic has been around a while. They changed their name quite a while ago, but at one point it was West Point Central Catholic. Several years ago, they became Guardian Angels Central Catholic, and since then, many around the state have referred to them as GACC, G-A-C-C. You see the fire in Aaron Losing's eyes. Trying to encourage this squad to get back in it, down by three, 38-35.
And you kind of wonder if he's going to stay in this zone much longer, right, if he's going to switch to man because of the three-pointers that Guardian Angels are capable of making and have been making here the second half.
Three on the way. Off the back of the rim, long rebound. And the Blue Jays just continue to get those long rebounds off those threes.
They do. The offensive rebounds, you know, is 11-6, and it really was pretty even until the second half here.
It's 4-0 here in the
right
fourth.
Now. Yeah, I think in the fourth quarter, you're right.
Yeah. That's the first rebound they've pulled down off of an offensive shot in this period by the Blue Jays. Three on the way is off, tipped around, and now Crofton gets one. Spots up, Sanger knocked it down. That's what Kelsey Sanger needs to be in the game. Big three-pointer, even at 38.
Yep, absolutely. She makes a difference with just handling the ball, you know, taking control out there on the field, or excuse me, on the court, and then also, you know, making those outside shots.
Good cut to the basket, the skip pass, and a foul called on Arms. And I believe that's going to be number 4 on Monica Arns. It is.
There's a look at this shot right here by Sanger to tie the game at 38 with 5:26 left.
You almost get the feeling that it's not when is someone going to foul out, or not if, but when one of these Warriors is. Both Arns and Sanger now have 4. Katie Peterson with 3. Free throw up and good by Alexis Hasse. She's just a sophomore.
And you never know. Maybe Crofton's used to this. They play that pressure man-to-man defense. Maybe they've been in this situation where they've had these fouls. They know the things that they can and cannot do with 5 minutes left if they have 3 or 4 fouls. Now, Guardian Angel stays in that 3-2 zone defense.
Another offensive rebound for the Warriors. Keeps it alive. Sanger with it now. Drops it off to Allen. Haven't heard much from Allen. She was red hot early on. Thought about it there. Good move with the bucket by Katie Peterson. Peterson, Sanger, Arms all in there with 4-4 and 3 fouls. And that was Peterson with the bucket. All tied at 40.
Guardian Angels being very patient. The three-point shot is when you miss like she did
there,
it's going to be that long rebound, and it just goes right back to the offense player standing on the outside.
So everybody needs to find a man and box out, right? Good example of it right there. As Sanger found the shooter, bodied her up, got the rebound. Great job of boxing out by that young freshman. And she gets the foul.
Number 34, Hannah Kenobi.
With it up top, down in the corner. Nearly a turnover. And a push called, and that will stay with the Warriors. I believe that's going to be called on Kate Kenobi.
Here's a look at that. A good steal back, you know, by Sanger to get that ball, which now puts Crofton in the 1-on-1.
And Kenobi now with 3. Gets the gentle roll and gives Crofton back the lead.
Yeah, which they have not had for quite a while. I think maybe it was back at 30-31 was the last time they had the lead.
Forty-two, 43 minutes
and some change left. Three on the way by Kenobi. That's off, tipped around. And the foul is gonna be called on Matty Kenobi. Third foul now on Matty, and that will put the Warriors back at the line.
Look at that rebound there on the end for Crofton by Katie Peterson. And now you're kind of seeing it kind of shift back the Crofton way. And with the Guardian Angels, you know, getting the fouls now.
But what a third period it was for the Guardian Angels and the Blue Jays. Put back here by Brown, Katie Brown. Good feed right back to Brown. Oh, great skip pass there, knocked down by Hossie.
Yeah, they really do a great job of being patient and moving the ball around to get that open shot.
Brown again. Brown, second leading scorer behind Kenobi for Guardian Angels Central Catholic. Stoiter and Hossie both have seven, so 9-8-7-7, very balanced. For GACC, Crofton is led right now by Sanger. She has 15. Despite sitting out nearly the entire third period, Arnes with 14 and Allen with 11. But both Arnes and Sanger, two leading scorers for Crofton right now, playing with four fouls. Certainly something to watch here in the last 3 minutes. They've been very careful, but at what point does that carefulness turn more into aggressiveness and they pick up a fifth. Katie Peterson knocks down the free throw, extends that lead to three. Here's the senior. Forward center knocks it down. She averages 11 points per game, and Peterson with five here tonight.
Crofton stays in that 2-3 defense right now.
Skip pass across to Hossie. Tried the dribble drive to Brown, not there. Skip pass across to Hossie again. Three-pointer on the way. That's going to be long. Rebound tipped around. Foul called. Looks like it's going to be called on Katie Peterson. If so, that would be four, and it is. Katie Peterson with four. Kelsey Sanger with four. Monica Arnes with four. Brianna Allen with three. Rolls off. Important free throw there. That's a travel. The Guardian Angels GACC has not hit in its last seven field goals. They have a scoring drought of 3 minutes. They have not scored in the last 3 minutes of the game, allowing Crofton to go on a 6-0 run and take this lead of 44-40.
Which was the opposite when they first came out this right. Half. Guardian Angels really went after and went on a scoring streak at the very beginning of the second half.
Blue Jays continue to move it around the perimeter. Now they get it inside. The turnaround. Can't get that roll. Pulled away by Arnes. Nice defensive rebound by Arnes.
That was a very strong rebound that she made there.
Now you see the strength of Sanger being able to get that ball across the midcourt with no trouble at all. And now Crofton will play a little bit of chew the clock.
Yep, they'll be very patient. Aaron Losing is, you know, putting his hands up just to be patient.
Now looking to draw the foul, the double team, and a timeout called by Losing. 1:32 to go, 4-point lead. Losing.
I think right now, probably, Aaron Losing is saying, you know, they're not shooting that bad of free throws. They need to keep it in probably either Allen's hands or Aaron's hands or Sanger's hands so that they can, you know, get them to the line here as they are going to be in that bonus there.
Hey, sports fans, NET is for you. We bring you more Nebraska high school championships and college sports than any other Nebraska network. For more information on dates, times, available webcasts, just visit our website at netnebraska.org. It is a rich tradition between these two schools. DAC has won championships in 2002, 3, 4, 5, and in 2012 they won it in Class D1. Crofton, championships in 2005, 6, 7, 12, 13, 14, 15, 4 in a row. And trying to make it 5 as they lead it by 4. Clock is Crofton. Here's Allen with it. And the foul on Sanger. Sanger will step to the free throw line and try to knock down 2 free throws and extend that lead to 6. 108 to go.
You know, and as you look at it, Crofton right now is shooting 12 of 15 free throws, 80%. That's pretty good free throw shooting here.
Absolutely.
I knew I would do it. Seems like every time you start talking about that at the free throw line, something happens.
So inside a minute to go, Crofton up by 4. Ball movement continues. Good patience here by the Blue Jays. They go inside and get the bucket from Matty Kenobi.
Well, it looks like they're going to have 5 out of 6 come down into the last
Absolutely.
Few seconds.
And the foul by Kate Kenobi. That's her 4th foul and sends Crofton back to the line. Now Crofton gets the point now where they must make these free throws. Here's Brianna Allen stepping to the line. Guardian Angels Central Catholic will take the timeout. So 36.6 left to go. Crofton up by 2, and it's Brianna Allen heading to the line to try to extend that to 4. We mentioned earlier, Crofton has won 4 consecutive state championships, going for 5. And in case you're wondering, the state record is 6 in a row. That's held by 2 different schools. South Sioux City won 6 in a row, and also Sandy Creek. Back, I believe it was late 80s, early 90s. Or check that, Sandy Creek's was in the late 90s, 96 through 2001. It was South Sioux's 6 in a row in a similar time frame from 2000 to 2005. But a win here tonight would make Crofton second all-time behind only those 2 schools. Several other schools have won 4 in a row. No one currently has won just 5 in a row. In fact, everyone who's won 5 in a row has gone on to win 6. South Sioux and Sandy Creek. First free throw missed, and you saw Allen's knees buckle as she missed it. Second one, that is off as well. Chance to tie it. 35 seconds to go here. C2 state championship game.
I stayed in that 2-3 zone.
Blue Jays fans on their feet. Down low, kicked it out. Ball movement continues. Hasse with it. Skip pass across. The drive by Brown puts it up. And the blocking foul will put Brown at the line and an opportunity to tie the game with 13.6 left.
And that gives Allen her 4th foul as well.
Oh my goodness.
You know, the other thing that comes into play here is we only have 13.6 seconds left. And if you have to foul, you're going to be careful who does that.
That's right.
Especially if you're thinking, I got to have these players if we go into overtime.
So the missed free throw means now that they can't tie it. 44-42, 13.6. Losing, screaming to his players, box out, need the rebound. Katie Brown shot. Knocks it down, and a timeout called by the Blue Jays. So they will set up the defense here and try to deny the inbounds, come up with the steal. If they can't steal, they'll foul very quickly.
And both teams have 2 timeouts remaining with 13.6 seconds left as well. And you know, Crofton, I'm sure, is setting up that play to try to get one of the guards that they've had, although those guards have missed the free throws here. But I'm sure Aaron Losing knows that those guards can put those free throws in here, and he wants it in probably either Sanger, Allen, or Aaron's right. hands on that inbound play. Just to mainly not only shoot the free throws, but just to take care of the ball. And that's what Sanger has done. And it's been a shift. We talked about that
right.
with her in the game now since she's come in.
There you see the foul trouble for Crofton. All four of those starters with four fouls. No one fouls out. That would be remarkable.
It would.
Given how long they have been sitting with three and four fouls. So Sanger, Ahrens, Peterson, Allen, all with four. All right, 13.6 to go. Warriors will try to get it inbounds. Blue Jays trying to deny it. And if the Warriors do get it in, there'll be a quick foul. It's a wide open back here at the wing, and finally they noticed it. The count is on. The break free by Sanger. And the quick foul by Kenobi.
Yeah, it was a little quick double screen. She went, Sanger went to screen, and then Allen screened for her to get that ball into Sanger.
Big free throws right here. 1 point game, 10.8 left. Sanger needs two to make it only a tie opportunity for GACC. Now a 2 point game. Yeah, you can feel the pressure here at Pinnacle Bank in Lincoln. Our final state championship of the day coming down to the wire like so many of them have today. Sanger got it. Big free throws by Kelsey Sanger. What a clutch performer by the junior who played most of this second half with four fouls and steps up and knocks two down when Crofton absolutely had to have them.
And you know, we talked about what the score was when she had to go out and how that changed for Guardian right. Angels to take over that game. And a lot of it is with her taking control of that basketball and also with her outside shots as well. So right now, they just need to pressure the ball. I mean, really, Guardian Angels has, they have 10.8 seconds left. They have plenty of time to bring the ball down. And they have some good outside three-point shooters. But I'm sure that Crofton now is going to change their defense. They have been in that 2-3 zone. This might be the time where Aaron Losing is now going to change into that man
right.
defense. Because if they shoot a two, that's fine. Just don't foul him.
Just don't foul, right. Well, the Blue Jays have only hit one of their last nine shots. And there you see the three-point field goals in the game. Crofton 6 of 18, Jack 5 of 18. 46-43. Inbounding it is Stoiter. Maddie Kenobi, well down the floor. There's Katie Brown. Kate Kenobi is in there, along with Stoiter and Hasse. Got it in. Dribbling up the floor, the far side, Kenobi. Hasse looking for the three. Three on the way, is off the top. Rebound, one more chance, no good. And for the fifth consecutive year, the Crofton Warriors are state champs. One for the thumb, ladies. Finish in a remarkable day of basketball right here on NET as we have brought you five of our six state championships that have come down to the final shot. When we come back, medal and trophy presentations. Stay with us on NET.
The Aurora Cooperative is reshaping the agricultural landscape through world-class agronomy, innovative grain marketing, energy, and animal nutrition. with the vision and financial strength to not just anticipate change, but create it. Driven by an unwavering commitment to the farmers and ranchers we serve, to their communities, and to the next generation of agricultural leaders. The Aurora Cooperative, growing opportunities.
I had 29 students in my class.
We've been together since kindergarten.
High school, 4 years of growing up.
Growing together. Senior year.
I am done with school.
I'm invincible.
They don't understand me.
Forget about it. Let's have fun.
I had 29 students in my class.
Coverage of the 2016 NSAA Girls High School Basketball Championships on NET is made possible in part by the Nebraska Soybean Board, the Nebraska Tourism Commission, Nebraska Public Power District, and Education Quest. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. 5 in a row for Crofton. What an amazing accomplishment for the Warriors. 15-game tournament winning streak and 5 state championships as the nets come down one more time. You wonder if they're going to have trophy cases for those nets and trophies up there in Crofton. They'll just keep building them. Now for medal and trophy presentations, let's go to our public address announcer.
The Nebraska School Activities Association, the Nebraska Coaches Association, and the Nebraska Athletic Administrators Association are proud to support positive sportsmanship during the state championships and throughout the season. At this time, we are pleased to present the Sportsmanship Award for Class C2. The trophy is graciously donated by Awards Unlimited. The official supporting partner of the sportsmanship program is the Nebraska National Guard. Making the presentation are Nebraska National Guard representatives, Command Chief Warrant Officer Teresa Domeyer, and Sergeant First Class Marin Stewart. Representing the NSI AAA, Jack Tarr from Malcolm High School, and the Nebraska Coaches Association Executive Director Darren Boysen. The Class C2 Sportsmanship Award winner is Superior High School. Congratulations, Superior High School. The Nebraska School Activities Association is honored to have medals and trophies for both of these outstanding teams. Presentations will be made by NSAA Executive Director Dr. Jim Tennifer and Board of Directors Jay Beller from Battle Creek, Dr. Troy Unziker from Alliance, and U.S. Bank Representative Steve Mayer. Here are the awards for your 2016 Class C2 runner-up Guardian Angels Central Catholic High School. Will head coach Jerry Strackey and your assistants please step toward the middle of the court to present the silver medals. Players, as your name is called, please come forward to receive your medals. Number 12, Michaela Tomka. Number 20, Morgan Brock. Number 24, Hannah Hunke. Number 34, Maddie Kenobi. Number 40, Sarah Werdekemper. Number 42, Lauren Wapke. Number 44, Allie Kenobi. Number 50, Maddie Bra. Number 52, Emily Reza. Number 10, Kate Kenobi. Number 14, Katie Brown. Number 22, Katie Stoider. Number 30, Alexis Hazy. Number 32, Brianne Krakemeyer. And now, here is the 2016 Class C2 NSAA State Basketball Runner-Up Trophy. Congratulations, Guardian Angels Central Catholic High School. And now, to your 2016 Class C2 State Champions, Crofton High School. Head Coach Aaron Losing, we have a special award for you. Now, Coach, would you and your assistants please present the gold medals to the members of your championship team? Players, as your name are called, please come forward to receive your medals. Number 4, Allison Tram. Number 10, Haley Arns. Number 12, Kyla Denninger. Number 14, Josie Sanger. Number 20, Caitlin Bornhage. Number 22, Sam Altwine. Number 40, Lauren Stefan. Number 42, Mariah Denninger. Number 44, Chelsea Wortman. Number 3, Brianna Allard. Number 5, Brittany Gunther. Number 24, Monica Arms. Number 32, Kelsey Sanger. Number 34, Katie Peterson. Presenting the team championship game ball from Farmers Mutual Insurance is Chairman, President, and CEO Mark Walls to Head Coach Aaron Losing. And now, here is the 2016 Class C2 NSAA State Basketball Championship Trophy. Congratulations, Crofton High School.
In a row, but I can assure you it does not get old. As they show off the championship trophy to the home crowd, those from their hometown here in Lincoln. State champs once again. Now let's go to Andy Kindy.
Here with head coach of the Guardian Angels Central Catholic, Jerry Strachey. Coach, you guys go on that big run in the third quarter, 13-1 run, and you're looking good going in the fourth. What was the difference down the stretch?
Execution there at the end on offense. You know, we had our chances, and, you know, things just didn't work out.
Yeah, I know it's difficult right now, but what do you say to your kids about how far they've come this season and how good they have been and leaving with a second-place trophy?
Yeah, they don't have anything to hang their heads about. I thought they played hard. They gave everything they had. We had a great group of seniors this year, played hard throughout their 4 years for me, and we're going to miss them.
And you talk about those seniors. There's a good group. You have a good core group coming back. How would this help in the foundation and maybe light the fire in the offseason?
Well, hopefully, you know, they'll work hard during the offseason and get a taste of what it's like to be in the championship game and work hard and try to get back here again.
And I think, and finally, asking you this, what is the one thing that you'll take away from this season?
You know, just the memories and the effort that these girls put through. You know, I'm just happy and pleased that they had a chance to experience this. You know, not too many teams get a chance at this. And, you know, and when they look back at it, they'll remember that, you know, they played here. So, like I said, that's a great experience.
I know they're very proud of you in West Point. Congratulations on a great season. Jerry Strachey, the head coach of GACC. Second place finish, runner-up. We'll hear from the Crofton Warriors, the C2 champs, straight ahead.
Are you cool to flex fuel? One in seven Nebraskans is driving a flex fuel vehicle, and many don't even realize it. With a flex fuel vehicle, you can fill up with any blend of American ethanol and gasoline, from E10 to E15, from E30 to E85, at any time, in any amount. Look for an insignia on your trunk or tailgate. You might have a yellow gas cap, or check your owner's manual. If you're cool to flex fuel, then look for a flex fuel pump in your neighborhood. Flex fuel blends with American ethanol.
Over the years, the Nebraska Chiropractic Physicians Association has supported many Nebraska athletes by helping them excel physically. But the mental game is just as important. That's why we're pleased to sponsor the NSAA Academic All-State Award Program, recognizing students and athletes who shine in the classroom and as leaders. We're proud to team up with these exceptional individuals. Together, we can continue to make Nebraska a great place to live, learn, and play.
Programming on NET Television is provided in part by the Dr. Tom and Dorothy Hallstrom Inspire Nebraska Athletics Endowment.
I wanted to get tickets to the Antiques Roadshow because I wanted to see everybody in person. My husband encouraged me, the old Sand Hills rancher. He said, you need to go. And so by golly, I called up and I joined NET, and which I've always been wanting to do anyway. So it was a win-win for me.
Coverage of the 2016 NSAA Girls High School Basketball Championships on NET is made possible in part by U.S. Bank, the Nebraska Corn Board, Constellation, and the Aurora Cooperative. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We couldn't do it without your support.
Well, another one goes down to the last shot, and that meant Crofton won it in Class C2. Fifth consecutive year. Let's take a look at the final statistics from this C2 title game between Crofton and Guardian Angels Central Catholic. The Blue Jays and the Warriors.
And you know, as you look through again, we don't see a whole lot of changes, except there's a couple of things. Yep. Obviously, you know, free throws.
Free throws are big.
Crofton shot 70% at the free throw line. That's pretty good. Yep. You know, we always talk about how free throws can make a difference throughout the game, and especially at the end. You know, one of the other big keys, though, is Guardian Angels. They had 20 second chance points, and a lot of those were right at the beginning of the second half. But then, you know, Crofton, I think, had to switch in that 2-3, and it almost made a difference.
Yeah.
You know, not only just because of the foul situation that they were in, but also not giving them as many second chances then after that as well.
Well, you see things clearing out here at the Pinnacle Bank Arena, but it's still hopping backstage. That's where Andy Kindy will be when we come back.
No matter how you look at it, animal agriculture helps Nebraska's economy. The livestock industry provides increased tax revenues for schools and community services. Livestock enterprises also create jobs while contributing to existing businesses such as local banks and grocery stores. A thriving livestock industry helps maintain our current way of life, but also provides opportunities for the next generation of farm families. The Nebraska Soybean Checkoff helps to raise awareness of the importance of animal agriculture to Nebraska.
When you've been around for more than a century, you understand the power of generations, the value of nurturing and developing those who will carry on the legacy of agriculture and food production. That's why the Aurora Cooperative helps young people gain the experience, expertise, and wisdom to feed the world, be good stewards, become responsible community leaders, and continue setting the example for the generations that follow. The Aurora Cooperative, growing opportunities.
Welcome back inside Pinnacle Bank Arena, the Crofton Warriors Again, Class C2 champions, fifth straight 46-43 winners over GACC here with the winning coach, Aaron Losing. Coach, never winning never gets old. How does this one feel?
This one's real special. I mean, most people around the state know what we graduated from last year. We graduated three college athletes, two of them playing high-level college basketball right now. So to have this group come in and really adjust to playing without those girls this year, it was a process. And we knew we'd be good, but you know, we had some injuries along the way and people had to adjust roles, and our depth was a little shorter than it was in some years. But our kids are fighters, and you saw that tonight, and really proud of them.
I was gonna ask you about tonight. You had so much foul trouble. How did you maintain that balance between being aggressive but not playing smart?
Yeah, I mean, we had to switch up. I thought we were playing great in our man-to-man defense, really giving them fits. But we got some kids with four fouls, and we just had to go 2-3 zone. I mean, we had to protect kids with the zone defense. And really it came down to, you know, we had to give them some open threes and protect the inside in the zone and hope that they missed some. And they made some, and they missed some, and we had trouble rebounding in the zone. But I thought when we were having trouble stopping them in the zone, we continued to play good on the offensive end, and we continued to be aggressive and attack the basket. In the end, it worked out for us.
I want to ask you one more. Well, how is this team different than the other previous four in a row?
You know, we got seven seniors this year. Never had a group of seven seniors this year. We got great leadership. You know, they all had different roles. Really unselfish group of kids. Everybody understood their spot on the team. You know, some of those seniors were practice players that motivated the other kids, and some of them had roles as far as getting lots of minutes. So from that aspect, this team was a little different. And I hope that filters down, that leadership and that unselfishness filters down to everybody for future years, because those seniors set a great example.
Well, we're going to talk to a senior and a couple seniors straight ahead. The Crofton Warriors, your state champions, 46-43 winners over GACC.
Constellation believes in developing the next generation of Nebraska leaders, and we show that support by contributing to 4-H and FFA in the 60 Nebraska counties we serve. More than $120,000 over the past 4 years. Constellation provides natural gas for Nebraska homes, farms, ranches, and businesses. Through our support for 4-H and FFA, we're providing energy for Nebraska's future as well. Natural gas from Constellation.
We buy smartphones. We buy clothes. We buy game consoles and TVs. Tickets to movies, concerts, and sporting events. It's kind of funny. We buy all these things to make us happy, when really, all we need is each other. A place where we can all connect and get away for a while. Wouldn't that be nice?
Crofton beats GACC 46-43. Let's talk to a couple of the winning Warriors. This is Brianna Allen, 11 points. She's a senior. She has gone 4 years and has won four championships. How does that sound?
It's amazing. It's really good to hear you say it, and it feels that much better. There's no words that can really explain how it feels.
How did you do it tonight?
Toughness really came out in the end. Our defense was shaky at times, but definitely helped us in the end. And tonight we were finally able to hit some shots, which really, really helped us out.
How were you able to balance the foul trouble? And you had to keep playing aggressively, but yet you all as a team had to watch your back, so to speak.
Yeah, they were definitely calling it close. And I think it took us a while to adjust. Maybe if we didn't even adjust, I don't really know. But we were all in some form of foul trouble, and it was kind of scary, but I think we played through it well.
Oh, you adjusted in just in time. All right, let's hand off the trophy to number 24, Monica Arnes, the junior. 14 points, 11 rebounds. Come on. Yeah, I know this was a physical matchup. How physical was it, and how beat up are you?
Yeah, it was pretty physical. They were tall and very tough. They're a tough team.
What was the difference down the stretch?
I just, you know, coach called a timeout, and he said the only way we're going to win this game is if we're tough, and that's something he's preached to us all season, is the tougher team will be at the top in the end, and I guess that was enough today just to be tough.
All right, and let me ask you this. What does it mean, you're a junior, so you've won three in a row. What would be your big takeaway from this team?
That no matter what happens early on in the season, you can always come back. It doesn't matter. The end of the season is what really matters, and if you keep pushing and keep improving to get to where you want to be, you can get there.
Peaking at the right time. Thank you very much. Congratulations. Let's hand it off to Kelsey Sanger, the junior, hitting some big, big shots late. I know you had to battle some foul trouble tonight. How were you able to balance being aggressive and yet playing smart?
He told me coming into that fourth quarter that I definitely couldn't foul, but I knew they made a big run there, and I knew that when I came in, I had to do everything I could to get us back into it, and I just did my best.
What does this mean to you? I mean, you've won them before. What does this one mean?
Each one is pretty special. I think this one's a little more special because these girls are like my sisters. I've been playing with them since I've been in fifth, sixth grade, and just makes the experience a little more special.
And I know that you are a junior and you have a whole bunch of seniors on this team. What did they mean to this team?
They were a very big part of this team. We got some big shoes to fill, but I think if we work hard enough, but like I said, they were very, very talented and we got some shoes to fill.
All right, go celebrate the Crofton Warriors. They came out to play 46-43 winners over GACC. We'll put a wrap on Championship Saturday straight ahead.
Programming on NET Television is made possible in part by U.S. Bank. U.S. Bank knows the importance of giving back. That's why we're committed to support charitable, educational, and service organizations in communities across Nebraska and the nation. Last year, U.S. Bank employees provided more than 3,000 hours of community service in Nebraska, and we're dedicated to continuing that support. U.S. Bank, serving you in Nebraska. Member FDIC.
For me, asking why is just getting started.
It's more than an activity. It's me doing what I love.
I'm not a stereotype. When I rewrite the rules, things get better.
I know that all these experiences matter.
These moments will help me become something more.
Little things always lead to something bigger.
Do it.
Track it.
Earn it.
What you're doing now will help you get scholarships later. Find resources from Education Quest at trackyoursuccess.org.
Your favorite PBS shows. Ready to watch when you are. Anytime, any place. Find more ways to explore than ever before.
Coverage of the 2016 NSAA Girls High School Basketball Championships on NET is made possible in part by the Nebraska Soybean Board, the Nebraska Tourism Commission, Nebraska Public Power District, and Education Quest. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. Back at Pinnacle Bank Arena, the final 46-43. Crofton wins it in Class C2. They are the state champs. And Trudy Nolan, what a day we had here with state championships coming down to the wire. Five of our six games, I believe, came down to the final shot, if not the shot before the final shot. But, you know, we start early this morning and, you know, that goes. It's a different story. And instead, it's a state championship. I believe for Emerson Hubbard. I think this is the second one of the day. Kearney puts that in. Lincoln Christian, if that goes. But Kearney hit the shot right before that to give them the lead, and Kearney Catholic wins it. Third game of the day, Elkhorn South Waverly. This is St. Mary's, why not? Yep, why not that shot? This is our fourth game of the day. And if that shot goes, St. Mary's is a state champ. Instead, why not win it on the shot before the last shot? And then finally in Class A, it was Lincoln East with that bucket with 5 seconds left. And oh, by the way, if this goes, will we go overtime?
Yep.
So the next to last shot, all of them decided on that last shot. And of course, the one we just saw in Class C2. If that shot or the next shot go, We go to overtime. Phenomenal finishes all day long. This as close and as exciting a state tournament from top to bottom as I can remember we've ever had on NET in the 15 years we've been doing it. Well, we've been doing it for more than 15 years, but I've been doing it.
I don't think so. I don't think we've ever had this many close games. And really, you know, Elkhorn South wins by 10 over Waverly, so not a huge win there either. But all the other five coming down to the last second. Just a great turnout for the teams that are here at the Girls State Basketball Tournament this year.
Well, we say thanks so much for joining us. It was our pleasure to bring you these state high school championships across the entire state of Nebraska. Don't forget to join us next week when we have the boys' state high school championships right back here on NET. So for Trudy Nolan and Andy Kendi and our entire NET sports production crew, I'm Larry Putney. Good night, everybody, from Pinnacle Bank Arena in Lincoln. We'll see you next week.